Please welcome the faculty of the College of Arts and Sciences.
Please be seated. Good afternoon. That was kind of quiet. Let's try it again. Good afternoon. Yay! I am Sally McCormick-Tutt. I'm the interim dean for the Westbrook College of Health Professions. I'm delighted to welcome you to the college undergraduate commencement ceremony. Yay! We are gathered today to honor and celebrate the graduates of the class of 2022. To each of our graduates, this is an important time in your life, the culmination of your studies, where you are formally transitioning from a student to a graduate that is transitioning into your chosen healthcare profession. Upon graduation, you become a member of an elite group. According to the U.S. Census Bureau, only 37% of adults in the U.S. hold a bachelor's degree. Your accomplishments are even more profound, having achieved this degree while having a good portion of your college career occurring in a global pandemic. This experience has truly shed light on the importance of the health professions amid this public health crisis. Completing your degree is a major milestone, but doing so at this historic time is truly an accomplishment. But we know these accomplishments and these achievements don't happen in a vacuum. You don't do this alone. You have the friendship of classmates who have become like a second family to you. Having graduated from UNE myself, I can tell you that even now, many years later, my UNE classmates are some of the friends that I call and talk to about life and work situations. You have the love and support of your parents, spouses, partners, siblings, children, and friends who propped you up on those difficult days. We collectively express our appreciation to your loved ones who have helped make today possible for each of you. A big thank you to them. In addition to your family and friends, there are your faculty. These are the individuals who have challenged you, encouraged you to do your very best, who set the bar high and supported and inspired you. These incredible teachers work tirelessly throughout your education. The past few years, they have had to pivot from typical campus-based lessons and laboratories to being creative with the delivery format to meet the current restrictions due to the pandemic. They demonstrated abundant creativity in their teaching. I commend their unwavering commitment to you, the students. From this day forward, this remarkable faculty are not only your teachers and mentors, but now they become your professional colleagues. So let's give a big thank you to the incredible and talented faculty of WCHB. As I reflect on what your class has gone through during their college career, you have all developed strong bonds with your peers, been challenged with your academics, and demonstrated grit and resilience through the past few years. Many of you even stepped up to support the community by volunteering your time in various ways. Some of you volunteered at the vaccine clinic across Southern Maine, while others spent time with some of our community partners to provide services through the Office of Service Learning. You may have participated in a community health fair through the Westbrook Housing Authority, volunteered at the Portland COVID shelter at Preble Street, provided preventative dental care to the community members in need, as well as educated elementary children on oral care. You are truly remarkable. The class of 2022 is strong, resilient, creative thinkers, and is exactly what this world needs. My father worked in healthcare all his life. He always talked about how a strong healthcare provider knows the science and the art of working with patients and clients. During your classes, labs, and internships, you acquired the knowledge and skill you need to master the science of healthcare in your chosen profession. Through the activities outside of your class, collaborating with your peers, and amid this crazy pandemic, you have strengthened your ability to apply the art of being a healthcare professional through your caring and compassionate acts. You are a very special graduating class. We will never forget you and all you brought to the Westbrook College of Health Professions. I would now like to introduce Dr. James Herbert, President of the United States. I just promoted him. President of the University of New England, maybe the United States at some point.
This is great. So it's only fitting that following 2 years of pandemic, when we had to, you know, adapt and roll with the punches, that we're first introduced as the College of Arts and Sciences, you know, demoted to the College of Arts and Sciences, and then that I become the President of the United States. Another demotion from the president of UNE. I would much rather have this job. So, but hey, that's what we do. We roll with the punches at UNE. So good morning, everyone, or good afternoon, right? There's another one. We'll see how many of these we can rack up. It's my pleasure to welcome you all to the celebration of our University of New England class of 2022, Westbrook College of Health Professions. So congratulations. So we are joined today by members of our senior leadership team, including the Dean of the Westbrook College of Health Professions, Sally McCormick-Tutt, and members of our distinguished faculty and professional staff. Joining us as well are the many parents and grandparents and other friends and family members of our health profession graduates. And let's acknowledge them once again, okay? All the family members, all the people who supported you all. Now, most importantly, we're joined by the exceptional people who will be awarded bachelor's degrees at our university-wide commencement ceremony tomorrow morning. Thank you all for being here, and welcome and congratulations. Graduates, over the past 4 years, I've had the pleasure of observing you firsthand at work on our campuses and in various clinical settings, and I know and I understand the magnitude of the impact you're now ready to make on our world. I visited our dental hygiene clinic and marveled at the professionalism and patience you display as you interact with patients. I've seen our applied exercise science students helping fellow students and other members of our university community, and including me, by the way, rehabilitate various injuries in our gyms. I've seen our nursing, health, wellness, and occupational studies, and other students engaging in interprofessional learning with students from other disciplines in our simulation labs. And at every step, I have been so impressed. You all are a truly gifted bunch, distinguished by your intelligence, diligence, creativity, and most of all, your compassion. Each one of you has chosen to pursue a caring profession. That says so much about who you are and what you value. Motivated by concern for others, you've committed yourself to the hard work required to gain the knowledge and skills to improve other people's lives. This weekend signals that you're ready to make the next step in your journey as healthcare professionals. And I can say with confidence that your future employers and coworkers, and most importantly, your patients, will be very lucky to have you by their side. With the in-depth knowledge of your disciplines and the extensive skills you've gained through your clinical experiences, you are ready. As you head into the field or off to a graduate program, you'll carry with you the commitment to practicing collaborative, team-based healthcare that we've worked so hard to instill in you. Our interprofessional approach positioned you side by side with professionals from other disciplines so you can learn how to interface with them in the context of each patient's treatment plan. This model, which UNE is proud to have pioneered and championed through the years, has shown you how much more you can accomplish collectively than merely on your own. I'm sure you will advocate for such a team-based approach in your future workplaces, and I have every confidence you will assume leadership roles before very long within the various teams that you'll join. Today, you should be very proud of yourselves for successfully completing one of our rigorous programs. I'd say that to any WCHP graduating class in any year, of course, but this year, I mean it even more so when I say it to you. These past few years have presented unprecedented challenges in education and in healthcare. Through its various stages, the pandemic forced us to adjust the way we taught and learned and treated patients, and yet each of you persevered. You rolled with the punches and you stayed on track in your studies and your clinical obligations. Along the way, you have no doubt gained additional grit and resilience, and these are qualities that will serve you well in the fields that are awaiting you. So I hope that you're as proud of yourselves as we all are of you, and I know that your professors and loved ones share that sense of pride that we have in you. You have earned the right to feel a deep sense of accomplishment that comes from tackling and succeeding at a difficult undertaking, and especially during a uniquely challenging time. So now, the next adventure in your professional journey begins, and we can't wait to see what you're gonna do next. But first, take this time to relish this time of celebration with your friends, your mentors, and your loved ones. Congratulations to you all.
Thank you, President Herbert. So I'm delighted to introduce to you Caitlin Quirk, who is a student in the Health, Wellness, and Occupational Studies, actually a graduate now, a student trustee, and the president of the UNE's class of 2022, and I'm also happy to say a colleague of mine now too, Caitlin.
Hello and welcome, family, friends, faculty, staff, alumni, and of course, the amazing class of 2022. My name is Caitlin Quirk, and I've had the pleasure and the privilege to be the class of 2022 president these past 4 years, and it is an honor to be speaking in front of you all today. I first want to take a moment to congratulate all the students sitting on the floor today. Your hard work and your dedication is noticed and valued. Amidst all the craziness and all the emotions that come along today with your college journey coming to an end, take a moment to appreciate where you started and where you are now. This is your moment and this is your day. As I reflect on our college experience, I remember being warned that the next 4 years were gonna fly by and to embrace all the moments that this opportunity was gonna bring. Nevertheless, they were right. Time really does fly when you're having fun. However, parents, I'm sure you're thrilled that our fun is over because you won't be paying any more tuition bills. But don't worry, Students Alumni Council will be in contact with us in 30 days to make a donation back to the school. So let's recap on our 4 years together at UNE, because we really have done some amazing things and have grown into really extraordinary people. Coming in as a first year, we helped each other transition to UNE, this brand new setting that quickly became our home away from home. We taught each other how to navigate this first trial year of college and establish a class of strong leaders. During our first year, we learned how to get involved in extracurriculars by walking around campus and involved at the involvement fair and signing up for anything that caught our eye, most of which we still aren't involved in today, but got to put on our resume for a good year. We even learned that our school had a ghost hunting and cereal eating club, because who would have guessed that? We learned how to log into UNLINE a minute early, which became a crucial hack for class registration so that we wouldn't be stuck with 8 a.m. labs or classes on that Friday morning. And we learned how to adjust to the quad with living with three roommates and absolutely zero personal space. But above all, we learned how to fulfill our college experiences without the RAs noticing us, luckily. Our sophomore and junior year, we continued to find ourselves while turning our attention to support the greater UNE community through multiple efforts and events. During this time, many of our classmates stepped up to be leaders in clubs and organizations, as well as our student athletes, making the Nor'easter fan section cheer loud and proud as they collected championship titles and trophies. While the world was crashing around us, our UNE bubble continued to strive, and we continued to maintain those personal and professional goals in the face of all challenges. As we wrap up this academic year, we can say that we have successfully persevered through the most unexpected of times, challenges, and obstacles. We have jumped over every hurdle that has been thrown at us. Well, almost walking across this stage today, we're still sitting all together. We have laughed, cried, maybe thought about quitting, but most importantly, we have made friendships that are sure to last a lifetime. We even have made some unforgettable memories, many of which aren't appropriate for me to share today on this stage, but we will hold them near and dear in our hearts. We sit here today as a group of accomplished individuals who are about to enter well-deserved seats in distinguished graduate programs, jobs, and research opportunities. We came to UNE unfamiliar with each other, just sitting together at orientation, and are now about to receive our degrees and leave UNE making a lasting impact on this university. As we embark on our newest adventures, it is important to first realize this. With all next steps, it can be really scary to enter a future that awaits numerous amounts of unknowns. Facing failure is expected, but in order to grow, leaps of faith will need to be taken to become the best versions of ourselves. We've already shown that we can be resilient and that we can tackle anything that comes our way. So we must remember to live life passionately and not be afraid to take those chances, as those chances just may turn out to be the best decisions we've made, just like when we chose to come to UNE. So to conclude, believe it or not, we are now the future. We now have all the skills and abilities to be successful and chase all of our wildest dreams. It is now time to take what we've learned these past 4 years and become a catalyst of change in wherever life may lead us. And even though this chapter of our lives is now coming to an end, it is only just the beginning, and I'm so excited to see what the future has in store for all of us. So congratulations again, class of 2022. We did it.
Thank you, Caitlin. I would now like to introduce Bernice Mills, Assistant Dean for Clinical and Student Affairs of the Westbrook College of Health Professions.
Good afternoon, and congratulations to all of the graduates and their families and friends. This is a very special weekend, and I hope you all take the time to enjoy it and to think about all you've done and the accomplishments that you have made. Now it is my pleasure
to announce the Maroon Award winners for the Portland and Biddeford campuses. The Maroon Award is an honor bestowed to the undergraduate student who has served as a role model for other students in their ability to demonstrate and maintain high academic standards, collaborative working relationships, and service to improve the quality of life for others. The Maroon Award began as a Westbrook College Outstanding Senior Award and has been modified over the years to accommodate institutional changes and traditions, and is now the highest honor bestowed upon an undergraduate student on the Portland and the Biddeford campus. At this time, I would like to recognize each of the candidates nominated for the Portland Campus Maroon Award. Please stand as I call your name. Sandra Chavez. Sandra is from the Accelerated Bachelor of Nursing program. Kyle McLaughlin, Bachelor of Science Nursing. Rachel Pion, Bachelor of Science in Dental Hygiene. And Laura Scally, Bachelor of Science in Nursing. I would ask the audience to join me in recognizing these students. You may be seated. I am pleased to announce that the recipient of the Portland Campus 2022 Maroon Award is Sandra Chavez. Would you please join me on the stage? Either way. As Sandra is joining us, let me just share a few words about Sandra. Not only has Sandra maintained an exemplary GPA in an academically rigorous accelerated nursing program, she has also served as a leader in the University of New England Student Nursing Association as a graduate and professional student association counselor. In her leadership role within the UNE Student Nurse Association, and just prior to being inducted into the Kappa Zeta at Large chapter of Sigma, which is a long name for the International Nursing Honor Society, Sandra recruited the largest number of nursing students ever to participate in the Kappa Zeta at Large chapter team for the Making Strides Against Breast Cancer Walk. Sandra is also a peer tutor in the UNE Student Academic Success Center and worked tirelessly to provide study sessions for her peers in collaboration with her faculty. Her peers see her as an informal leader in class, as she's typically identified as the leader of any team for which she is assigned. While here at UNE, Sandra served as a patient services representative on the Maine Medical Partners Pandemic Response Team, where she worked to educate patients on the most current CDC guidelines and helped to answer their questions. One faculty member said, quote, "Given Sandra's kind, friendly, humble, and professional demeanor, she creates a trusting environment and easily puts people at ease," end quote. For your commitment to academics, your leadership, and service to your fellow students and the community, I am honored to present you with the 2022 Portland Campus Maroon Award. Congratulations.
Congratulations.
Okay.
I would now like to recognize each of the candidates nominated for the Biddeford Campus Maroon Award. Please stand as I call your name. Katie Berger, Bachelor of Science, Applied Exercise Science. Alyssa Ehrenfield, Bachelor of Health Science, Athletic Training. Caitlin Kluge, Bachelor of Science, Health, Wellness, and Occupational Studies. And Sydney Wolf, Bachelor in Social Work. Thank you. You may be seated. Passion, professionalism, ability to motivate and organize others toward community engagement and improvement, persistence, leadership. These are just some of the words used to describe the recipient of the Biddeford Campus 2022 Maroon Award recipient. Sydney Wolf, would you please join me on the stage? Not only has Sydney excelled academically while here at the University of New England, her commitment to service and overall wellness of the UNE community is remarkable. As a sophomore student, Sydney saw the impact that mental health was having on her peers and set out to create a chapter of the national student organization, Active Minds, on the UNE campus. Active Minds seeks to break the stigma associated with mental health and create an environment that encourages conversation, advocacy, and support. As the founder and president of Active Minds, Sydney began recruiting students to become advocates and started organizing several events, including Smash the Stigma, the Green Bandana Project, a collaboration with UNE's Green Dot program, as well as an interprofessional signature event titled Athletes and Mental Health, The Hidden Opponent, which was attended by over 200 students. In the fall of 2022, Sydney created a campus-wide stigma reduction campaign, an award-winning workshop series titled Active Mindsology. This was a semester-long educational series that included 5 opportunities for students to join via Zoom to talk about topics such as resiliency during COVID, supporting each other's mental health, and others. She also worked with the UNE administration to have a crisis telephone number printed on UNE ID cards. Sydney is one of the inaugural work-study students in the Office of Title IX and Civil Rights Compliance. She's used her role to invite partnerships and student groups across the university to increase prevention and awareness efforts around relationships and sexual violence. A faculty member wrote, quote, "To know Sydney is to see the hope and response and possibilities of a more compassionate and kind world. She is passionate about helping others and charting pathways towards social justice, inclusion, and equality." Sydney's significant and sustaining contributions to the University of New England has made a positive impact on our community, end quote. For your commitment to your academics, your leadership, and service to your fellow students and the community, I am honored to present you with the 2022 Biddeford Campus Maroon Award. Thank you. I would now like to introduce Sarah Vincent, Interim Assistant Dean for Academic Affairs of the Westbrook College of Health Professions.
Hello. It's now my pleasure to award the Westbrook College of Health Professions Undergraduate Distinguished Teaching Award. This award recognizes and honors excellence in teaching, advising, and supporting of students, as well as serving as a role model for students and other faculty. It's important to note that this award is selected based on written nominations received from students. There were 8 faculty nominated for this award this year. At this time, I would first like to recognize 7 of the individuals who received nominations. Being nominated is an important honor in and of itself, and I would like to take this opportunity to acknowledge this important distinction. Would the following nominees please stand? Ashley Skulak, Assistant Clinical Professor, Nursing. Chris Delenick, Assistant Clinical Professor, Health, Wellness, and Occupational Studies. Denise Blaze, Assistant Clinical Professor, Nursing. Jamie Bullock, Assistant Clinical Professor, Nursing. Kristen Bailey, Associate Clinical Professor, Athletic Training. Lauren Durrell, Visiting Assistant Associate Clinical Professor, Dental Hygiene. Nancy Vaugh, Clinical Associate Professor of Nursing. Listen to that applause, I love it. Congratulations to each one of you on being recognized by your students as possessing the exemplary characteristics inherent in the Distinguished Teaching Award. And now for our recipient. The 2022 Undergraduate Distinguished Teaching Award is presented to Joanne Moulton. Assistant Clinical Professor in the Dental Hygiene Program. Professor Moulton, please come up to the stage. When describing Professor Moulton, the students noted that Joanne truly cares about her students and wants everyone to succeed. She's described as taking the time to help students prepare, understand, and review challenging content for the board exam. She serves as an inspiration to her students, demonstrating commitment and passion towards her profession. Finally, the nomination noted that Professor Moulton's dedication to her students and wealth of information has been a major factor for students to feel confident about passing the boards and being able to succeed as a practicing hygienist. I am honored to be able to present this award to Professor Moulton. To begin the presentation of our Academic Program Awards for Outstanding Academic Achievement, I would now like to invite Professor Heath Pierce, Program Director, Applied Exercise Science, to come to the podium.
Good afternoon, everyone. It is an honor to present the 2022 Outstanding Academic Achievement Award for the Applied Exercise Science Program to Katie Berger. Katie, will you please join me at the podium? Katie's academic achievements include highest GPA in the major, Dean's List all 8 consecutive semesters, Alpha Chi National Honor Society member, graduating with highest honors. Katie will be attending Seattle University, pursuing an MBA in sport and entertainment management beginning in June. On behalf of the Applied Exercise Science Program, I would like to commend you on your hard work and dedication. We are proud of you and your accomplishments. Congratulations, Katie. Please help me in congratulating Katie. I would now like to introduce Professor Margie Harmerbean, Director of Dental Hygiene, to the podium. Thank you.
Good afternoon.
It should have been right there.
Oops, sorry. Oh, thank you. I needed help. Good afternoon, and congratulations to the class of 2022. I have the distinct honor of awarding our highest GPA program award to Mallory Feenstra. Unfortunately, Mallory was not able to be here today. However, I would like to tell you a little bit about her. She came to us from Berwick, Maine. Mallory is an unassuming student who shines with her excellent academic prowess. She has justifiably earned her privileged membership in Alpha Chi National Honor Society and Dean's List. Recently, she did Dental Hygiene proud. She was interviewed by Channel 8 News. And she talked about a pop-up clinic at the Westbrook Housing Authority, and that brought distinction upon herself and our program. She prides herself on her outstanding ability to focus on the individual patient as a whole person. Her career path is to be part of the dental team. Congratulations, Mallory. Let's all show Mallory. No, she's not here today. Thank you. I'd like to introduce and call Chris Rizzo to the podium.
Good afternoon. I'd like to begin by congratulating all of the members of the class of 2022. It is my honor to present the Outstanding Student Award to our member of our inaugural Health Science Athletic Training Cohort. Would Jordan Strum please join me at the podium? It's a pleasure for me to present this award to Jordan. Jordan is graduating summa cum laude for our inaugural baccalaureate cohort of Health Sciences Athletic Training students. Jordan has had an impressive and well-rounded undergraduate career, having served as captain of the women's softball team and also vice president for our athletic training club. Jordan will be completing an immersive clinical experience at the University of Massachusetts Amherst next year with their Division I hockey team. Congratulations, Jordan. I would now like to introduce Professor Karen Hussman, Program Director from Health, Wellness, and Occupational Studies.
Good afternoon. I'm honored to present the Health, Wellness, and Occupational Studies Academic Achievement Award to Carly Walker. Carly is an outstanding student. She's insightful, thoughtful, and diligent. She demonstrates intellectual curiosity, humility, and a fun-loving attitude. During her time as a student at UNE, Carly has served as a reading tutor at the Ocosisco School, a representative for the Student Athlete Advisory Committee, and as social media liaison for the Female Athlete Alliance. Carly is dedicated to finding innovative ways to help people improve their health and wellness. Congratulations, Carly. I would now like to introduce Dr. Jen Morton, Program Director for the Nursing Program.
Good afternoon, everyone, and congratulations to the class of 2022. The School of Nursing and Population Health shares in the pride and joy felt by your family and loved ones. At this time, I would like to present the Academic Achievement Awards for our Baccalaureate of Science Nursing program, as well as the Accelerated Baccalaureate of Science in Nursing. Would Carson Wheeler and Sandra Chavez come join me on the stage? Carson, standing beside me, is our BSN student and holds an extremely high bar for herself academically. She has a thirst for knowledge and strives to be the absolute best she can be. Carson has served as a peer tutor in the Student Academic Success Center, supporting other students in the School of Nursing and Population Health. One clinical instructor reported, "Carson demonstrates true professionalism, the ability to adequately manage a patient assignment while providing safe, quality care to each and every one of her patients. Her ability to adapt to changing situations, attentiveness to her patients' needs, and calming bedside manner did not go unnoticed during her time at UNE." Congratulations.
Thank you.
Sandra Chavez is the recipient of the Academic Achievement Award for our Accelerated Nursing Program. In her quest for a second degree in nursing, Sandra quickly became noticed as a high achiever. She is also a champion for the achievement of her peers, as you heard earlier, serving as the tutor in the Academic Student Success Center. She went above and beyond to help students, often flexing her own packed schedule as an accelerated nursing student to meet their needs for additional support before her own crucial exams. Her passion for learning in the health professions came through every session she led. That passion made the sessions engaging, and warmth and openness built an essential foundation of trust with her peer students. I would like to congratulate Sandra on this wonderful achievement. I would now like to introduce Professor Heath Pierce, Program Director for Applied Exercise Science.
It is my honor to present the 2022 Outstanding Academic Achievement Award for the Nutrition Program to Christiana Ingalls. Christiana, could you please join me at the podium? Christiana is passionate about nutrition and helping others. In the classroom, she excels. In her coursework, and always ask profound questions applying concepts she's learned. She has the highest GPA in the nutrition program and has achieved Dean's List for 6 consecutive semesters. She has an organized, successful food drive for local schools and advocated for low-income households. Through efforts like these, Christiana will improve the lives of others and will make the world a better place. Please join me in congratulating Christiana. I now would like to introduce Dr. Jen Morton, Director of Nursing and Public Health, for the podium.
Good afternoon again. I am here to present the award for the Undergraduate Public Health Program. I am presenting on behalf of Bethany Fortier, who couldn't be here today, but the beloved faculty member of that program. I would like to introduce Olivia Rando to the stage. It's my distinct honor to present Olivia with the Undergraduate Public Health Academic Achievement Award. Olivia is an exceptional student and proven leader, both in and out of the classroom. Olivia has a bright future in public health field ahead of her. Congratulations, Olivia, and we look forward to the wonderful things that you do to change the lives of so many folks in public health practice. Congratulations. I would now like to introduce Dr. Cindy Amato, Bachelor of Science, Bachelor of Social Work Program Director, to the stage.
Good afternoon, everybody, and congratulations, class of 2022. Just love seeing all of your faces. So this year, for the Bachelor's of Social Work, this year award goes to Allie Bolton. Allie has demonstrated high academic standards, I'll wait for her to get here, including maintaining the highest GPA of her social work major cohort, with the added accomplishment of completing a minor in education. She possesses a natural curiosity about the world around her, a willingness to speak up and ask hard questions, the perseverance to achieve high standards, and genuine care for her peers and their well-being. All of these traits will serve her well as she embarks on her path to make the difference in lives of others. Congratulations, Allie.
Thank you to our program directors and representatives, and congratulations to all the award recipients. And now, would the marshals please escort our applied exercise performance, dental hygiene, health sciences, health wellness and occupational studies, nursing, nutrition, public health, and social work students, class of 2022, to the platform for pinning. I invite Professor Heath Pierce and the representatives of the applied exercise science profession to pin candidates in the AES program.
Alden Barrett Balbone, magna cum laude. Catherine May Berger, summa cum laude. Jocelyn K. Bolduc, magna cum laude. Matthew C. Cardona. Danielle Clymer. Cameron Robert Allen Crocker, magna cum laude. Julia Louise Curro. Allison DeFeo. Eleanor M. Decker, magna cum laude. Jared Christopher Duffy. Megan Elizabeth Thecto, magna cum laude. Natalie Marie Freeman, summa cum laude. Morgan A. Gamble. Mackenzie Elise Gilmore, cum laude. Matthew Stephen Harkins. Sydney Lynn Hurst, cum laude. Luis Paul Izzy Jr., cum laude. Owen James Kelly, cum laude. Grace W. Libby, summa cum laude. Kelly Marie Mahoney, magna cum laude. Mackenzie Hall Mahoney, magna cum laude. Mia Grace Martell, cum laude. Jack Bradford Martin, cum laude. Matthew Whiting McLeod, cum laude. Caroline Mius, magna cum laude. Austin Scott Morgan, cum laude. Carolyn Sue Nevin, cum laude, interprofessional honors. Brittany Lee Norman, cum laude. Victoria G. Powers, magna cum laude. Kyle T. Pryor, cum laude. Mark Anthony Rea. Caitlin Mary Riordan, magna cum laude. Alexandria Danielle Rousseau, cum laude. Connor J. Sirois, summa cum laude. Michael Patrick Spillane, cum laude. Carly R. Stroshine, magna cum laude. J. Jessica Elizabeth Tolsman, magna cum laude. Connor Alex Whitehead, magna cum laude. Ty Toby Williamson, cum laude. Professor Heath Pierce will lead the class of 2022 in the Applied Exercise Science oath.
Okay, class of 2022 Applied Exercise Science, please stand with me, please. You have programs there that have the oath as well as on our screens. I'm going to have you repeat each sentence after me. As a graduate of the Applied Exercise Science program at the University of New England, I will respect the rights and dignity of all. I will commit to provide competent, preventative, and rehabilitative healthcare services and never place financial gain above individuals' welfare.
I will commit to
provide Excellent. I will abide by all American College of Sports Medicine and National Strength and Conditioning Association standards and guidelines. I will participate in continuing education that will enhance my knowledge, skills, and abilities.
I will participate
I will provide only those services for which I'm qualified through education or experience as an exercise science professional. Congratulations, class of 2022. You may be seated. I invite Professor Margie Harmerbeam and the representatives of dental hygiene profession to pin candidates in the dental hygiene program. Thank you.
Madeline Rose Antonetti. Avery Brooke Backus, summa cum laude. Camden Maxine Barry Grant, magna cum laude. Alyssa Marion Bigos, cum laude. Jessica Sarah Brenna, summa cum laude.
My middle name is Nicole, Katie Nicole Bridges. I lost my card.
I got you here. Katie Nicole Bridges.
Hey, Katie.
Thank you, sir. Lauren Dean Brown. Riley May Boubier, cum laude. Lauren Faith Carey, cum laude.
I'll skip them if they are.
Taylor T. Cassidy, magna cum laude. Lacey Marie Cheney. Abigail Rebecca Clark. Hannah Catherine Douglas, cum laude. Lindsay Nicole Druin, magna cum laude. Sarah Elizabeth DuPont, magna cum laude. Brianna Marie Fontes, magna cum laude. Abigail Mariana Frazier, cum laude. Sadie Lynn Amanda Garsow, cum laude. Caitlin Rosalie Genest, magna cum laude. Michaela Anya Godzik. Jillian Jean Gross, cum laude. Rebecca Lynn Hanscom. Cassidy Althea Harriman, magna cum laude. Tina Tan Huang, cum laude. Lily Annie Humarian, cum laude. Molly Susan Jakes, magna cum laude. Sydney Amrell Jones, magna cum laude. Hannah Lynn Kaplan, cum laude. Tara Lee Kearney, summa cum laude. Kaylee Rose Kogan, cum laude. Sarah Catherine Lorello, cum laude. Jamie Ann Lynch, magna cum laude. Brittany McCauley, cum laude. Audrey Rose Martin. Jessica Rose Meyer, magna cum laude. Ariel Juliet Michaud. Twin X Nguyen. Magnolia M. Nishin, cum laude. Ainsley Joyce Pagano, cum laude. Rachel Amber Pion, summa cum laude. Alona Popoff, summa cum laude. Carly Gannett Quinn, magna cum laude. Lainey Alexia Richards. Megan Marie Robert, magna cum laude. Kendra Alexia Swift. Allie Ann Toof, magna cum laude. Erica Verville, cum laude. Chelsea Ray Valletta, magna cum laude. Thank you. Shelby Alexandria Ward, magna cum laude. At this time, I'd like to invite Professor Margie Harmer-Beam to lead the class of 2022 in the dental hygiene's oath.
Are you ready? All right. In my practice as a dental hygienist, I affirm my personal and professional commitment to improve the oral health of the public, to advance the art and science of dental hygiene, and to promote high standards of quality care. I pledge continually to improve my professional knowledge and skills to render a full measure of service to each patient entrusted to my care, and to uphold the highest standards of professional competence and personal conduct in the interest of the dental hygiene profession and the public it serves. You may be seated.
Professor Karen Hussman will lead the class of 2022 in the Health, Wellness, and Occupational Studies. Oh, wait, let's introduce them first. Bear with us here. I'm inviting Professor Heath Pierce and the representatives of the health sciences profession to pin the candidates in the health sciences program.
Laura Judith Donaty. Benjamin John Jackson. Grace Catherine Sabatino. Benjamin Togas. Shane Patrick Alercio, cum laude. Michelle Christine Barr, cum laude. Michaela Ann Davis. Alyssa W. Ehrenfried. Benjamin K. Louis, cum laude. Elizabeth Jane Schurich. Jordan Kaylee Strum, summa cum laude. Catherine Julia Wilmot, cum laude. Would the Health Sciences class of 2022 please stand and join me in reciting the Health Sciences oath? One sentence at a time. As a graduate of the Health Sciences of the University of New England, I will respect the rights, welfare, and dignity of all, be committed to providing competent care, and never place financial gain above the patient's welfare or participate in any arrangement that exploits the patient. I will be familiar with and abide by all of my profession standards, rules, and regulations, and I will participate in continuing education activities that enhance my skills and knowledge. Lastly, I will provide only those services for which I am qualified through education or experience, and which are allowed by my Practice Act and other pertinent regulation. Well done. I invite Professor Karen Hussman and the representatives of the Health, Wellness, and Occupational Studies profession to pin candidates in the Health, Wellness, and Occupational Studies program.
Would the candidates please step forward? Devin Elise Haynes Aparicio, summa cum laude. Chloe Marie Armilati, cum laude. Thomas J. Bartok III, magna cum laude. Wyatt J. Blackstone, cum laude, interprofessional honors. Lauren Elizabeth Boatwright, magna cum laude. Victoria Eve Bowler, magna cum laude, interprofessional honors. Caitlin Elizabeth Bubnowitz, magna cum laude. Sarah Jean Burbridge, magna cum laude, interprofessional honors. Stephanie Ashley Burns, cum laude, interprofessional honors. Molly Jean Cadigan, summa cum laude. Rebecca Ann Corbett, magna cum laude. Noelle Elizabeth Cody, summa cum laude. Gabriella Egg Krugnali, cum laude. Emma Marie DiBraccio. Jake Edward Hickey, summa cum laude. Hannah Paige Hutchins, cum laude, interprofessional honors. Caitlin B. Hutchins, magna cum laude. Caitlin Angela Kluge, summa cum laude, interprofessional honors. Elizabeth Ann Nell, summa cum laude, interprofessional honors. Jonathan D. Laurie, summa cum laude, military honors. Hannah B. Libby, summa cum laude. Bailey Angeline Lynch, cum laude, interprofessional honors. Mackenzie Paige McHatton, cum laude. Abigail Nora McKenna, cum laude. Megan Braley McLaughlin, cum laude. Taylor Michelle McPartlin, magna cum laude. Patrick Michael Mead, summa cum laude. Monique Millette, cum laude.
Go Monique!
Evan A. Moulton, magna cum laude. Grace Elizabeth Oliveira, summa cum laude. Kaylee Lynn Pimentel, cum laude. Caitlin M. Quirk, summa cum laude. Madeline C. Sanborn, magna cum laude. Danielle S. Skinner, magna cum laude, interprofessional honors. Michaela Lynn Svensson, cum laude, interprofessional honors. Gabriel Weston Tarbuck. Sierra Marie Tart, cum laude. Megan Grace Thomas, cum laude. Alicia Fionda Valeri, magna cum laude. Carly May Walker, summa cum laude. Shiloh Ray Yake.
Would the class of 2022 stand and join me in reciting the Health, Wellness, and Occupational Studies Oath? In accordance with my education in Health, Wellness, and Occupational Studies at the University of New England, I vow to conduct myself with the utmost respect for the rights and dignity of all people. I commit myself to ethical and compassionate practice with people of all races, abilities, and belief systems. I will promote wellness and engagement in meaningful occupations across the lifespan. I will advocate for the inclusion and occupational justice of all people within the societies they live, work, and play. Congratulations. I invite Dr. Jennifer Morton and the representatives of the nursing profession to ping candidates for the nursing program.
Grace Elaine Ogier, magna cum laude. Kathleen Rose Berry, cum laude.
Just put her face down afterwards.
Anna Christine Baudet, magna cum laude. Taylor Binney, magna cum laude. Ryder Daniel Bluen, cum laude. Alyssa Rose Boylard, summa cum laude. Audrey Lynn Bork, cum laude. Daisy Meredith Bryant, cum laude. Amanda Maria Bushway, summa cum laude. Evan Marie Carroll, cum laude. Abby Elizabeth Cavallaro, cum laude. Hajra Chand, cum laude. Sandra Chavez, summa cum laude. Cameron Marie Compton, military honors. David Alexander Correa, cum laude. Tessa Andrea Crovetti, magna cum laude. Arman Dadras, cum laude. Taylor May Depot, magna cum laude. Madison Paige DeRosa, cum laude. Stephanie Marie DeFrancesco, magna cum laude. Diana Ray Elgin. Mark Applebaum, magna cum laude. Krista Lee Fletcher, cum laude. Caroline Danielle Ford. Joanna M. Forrestall. Kateri B. Gomes, summa cum laude. Alexandra N. Goodman. Jennifer Elise Gore, cum laude. Catherine Brennan Griffin. Alexandra Jane Hall. Catherine Rose Hancock, summa cum laude. Olivia Grace Harnum. Bryn Hayland, magna cum laude. Haley Hedges, magna cum laude. Kathleen Humphreys, magna cum laude. Roxana Grace Hurlbert, magna cum laude. Kimberly Hurtado Ibarra, summa cum laude. Ulawaku Arija, cum laude. Eileen Johnston, magna cum laude. Emma Mary Cast, magna cum laude. Woo! April Marie Cluth, cum laude. Bianca Marie Crepien, cum laude. Catherine Ann Couquet, summa cum laude. Alyssa Marie Lambert, cum laude. Hallie Marie La Tulipi. Ziana Marie League. Nicole Marie LeBlanc, cum laude. Michaela Grace Littlefield, cum laude. Samantha Lynn Ljunggren, cum laude. Kimberly Ann Loomis. Emma Grace McDonald, magna cum laude. Paige Cassidy Mayhew, magna cum laude. Michael Anthony Mamoni. Allison Therese Martel, magna cum laude. Savannah Marie Martin. Alessandra Rose Martacci, cum laude. Maggie Noel Maznicki, cum laude. Lauren Anna Mazzotta, cum laude. Kyle Edward McLaughlin, magna cum laude. Maeve Judith McPhail. Haley Marie McCray, magna cum laude. Bethany L. Merchant. Abigail Marie Moisan, magna cum laude. Haley Montminy. Elizabeth Louise Rando, cum laude. Riley Christopher Ray. Emma Catherine Root, cum laude. Laura N. Scally, summa cum laude. Corinne Renee Shea, magna cum laude. Emily Ann Simpson, magna cum laude. Alexis Lorraine Torres, summa cum laude. Nicholas Robert Triggs. Kelly Claire Van Dam. Elizabeth Jane Walsh, cum laude. Carson Shayna Wheeler, summa cum laude. Christina Wolf, summa cum laude. Sarah Elizabeth Woodward, cum laude. Tyler Mark Wright, cum laude. Janissa May Yates, magna cum laude. Ebenezer Perfect Yeboa.
As Ebenezer makes his way down, with the both cohorts in the School of Nursing, please stand. You're going to use bold and intentional voices as you repeat after me. In the full knowledge of the responsibilities I'm undertaking, I promise to care for my clients with all of the knowledge, skills, and understanding I possess. Without regard to race, color, creed, politics, social status. Sparing no efforts to conserve meaningful life. To alleviate suffering and to promote health. I will respect at all times the dignity and religious beliefs of the patients under my care, and hold in the professional confidence of all personal information entrusted to me. I will refrain from any action that might endanger the quality of life or health. I will endeavor to keep my professional knowledge and skill at the highest level and to give my support and cooperation to all members of the health team. With full awareness of my qualifications and limitations, I will do my utmost to maximize the potential of the nursing profession and to uphold and advance its standards. Well done. I invite Professor Heath Pierce and the representatives of the Nutrition Department to pin candidates in the Nutrition Program.
Alexandra Morgan Fowler, cum laude. Christiana Kelly Ingalls, cum laude. K. Kaylee Jane Uresk. Nutrition class of 2022, would you please stand? Please recite each sentence of the oath after me. Make sure it's up. As a nutrition graduate, I would adhere to the core values of the profession with a focus on my patients or clients while maintaining integrity, social responsibility, and respecting diversity. I will practice with innovation, using evidence-based approach within my area of expertise, continuously developing and enhancing my knowledge and skills in the field. I will engage in constructive dialogue, demonstrating respect, civility, and professionalism in all my communications. Well done. Congratulations. I invite Dr. Jen Morton and the representatives of the public health profession to pin candidates in the public health program. Thank you.
Amanda Mary Gagne, Interprofessional Honors. Owen Robert Nelson, Magna Cum Laude, Interprofessional Honors. Olivia Marie Rando, cum laude, interprofessional honors. Dr. Jen Morton will lead the class of 2022 in the public health oath.
Would the public health students please stand and recite the oath? Be bold, you're small but mighty. Health is a human right. The public health community exists to safeguard that right. I commit myself to the following principles. I will work to ensure that people have the chance to live full and productive lives. I will hold myself to the highest ethics, standards, and values as I promote the science and practice of public health. I will respect the rights, values, beliefs, and cultures of those individuals and communities with whom I work. I rely on evidence to support my decisions and actions. I will advance equity and justice. I will collaborate with individuals, communities, and professionals who work to protect and promote health. With this oath, I pledge to uphold the ideals and missions of public health. Nicely done. I invite Professor Valerie Jones and representatives of the Social Work Department to pin candidates in that program.
Allison B. Bolton, summa cum laude. Christine Constant, cum laude. Audrey Gavin, magna cum laude. Carly May Michaud, summa cum laude. Sydney Marie Wolf, summa cum laude. Thanks.
So would the class of 22 stand and join me in reciting the social work oath? Okay, ready? Okay. As a bachelor's prepared social worker, I will abide by the profession's code of ethics and engage in practice that is culturally responsive and trauma-informed, respectful of the complexity and diversity of people's lives and circumstances, recognizes social exclusion prevents people from full and just participation, in their communities as a consequence of inequities, discrimination, stigma, and disadvantage. Demonstrates social responsibility, thereby raising public awareness and advocating with and on behalf of those whose voices are silenced. Supports person-centered collaborative partnership that unite diverse workers and community members to meet the best interest of individuals, families, and groups. Excellent. Well done.
You did it. Congratulations. On behalf of WCHP, I'm honored to extend our congratulations to each and every one of you. As I reflect back to how it felt to be graduating from UNE with my degree in physical therapy, I recall how excited and also nervous I was about what is to come next. Are any of you nervous? Take some time today to just rejoice in the amazing accomplishment you have achieved. Know that you will continue to grow and learn beyond this point in your life, because working in the health professions requires you dedicate yourself to being a lifelong learner. But be sure to take a deep breath and celebrate this special moment. I have just a few parting thoughts for you. We're almost done. As you have done the past 4 years, don't forget to give back to others and to your community, because the world needs more kindness and generosity. Don't be afraid to take risks. We often learn more from our failures than we do from our successes. Remember to enjoy the little things in life, because they truly do mean so much. And finally, choose to be happy. You can either be filled with despair over what did not work out, or you can be abundantly grateful for all that you have. Life is much happier if you look at the half full instead of the half empty. Congratulations, class of 2022. We can't wait to see what lies ahead for you. Please stay in touch with us. You will always be a part of UNE and the Westbrook College of Health Professions. Congratulations.